This tutorial will show how to get started with a form within the Google Drive app. To begin, come over to the left-hand side of the Google Drive interface and click on Create. From the drop-down menu, click on Form. Give a name for your form, and then choose from one of the available themes on the screen. I'm going to choose Notepaper. Once you've chosen a theme, go ahead and click OK. Now let's do some form setup. At the top of the screen, we have Form Settings. This is where you can turn certain things on, like, for example, require York School Department login to view this form. This comes in handy if you want to restrict access to the form to only a certain group of people, like only students in the York School Department or staff. If you want this form accessible to the public, because say you're going to publish this on the web and open it up to a larger audience, you would deselect this square. The second one says automatically collect respondents, York School Department username. This means you don't have to ask the users to provide their username or name or other identifying characteristic. The form will collect that automatically when they've logged into their department account. And then finally, if you'd like to show a progress bar at the bottom of the form, so that the user knows if they're 25%, 30%, 70% through the form, you can check off this box. Now let's scroll down to the bottom of the page. Here we have confirmation page. This is the page that will be displayed to users after they finished the form and clicked the final submit button. You can provide your own unique response when they're finished. We'll say thank you. You can have a link on the page to go and retake the form. This is good if you have multiple people cycling through on a few computers to take the form. If you like to give users access to a summary of the results of the form, like this is a graph of the results based on each question, you can check this off. And if you would like to allow responders to go back and edit their responses, even though they've already hit the submit button, you would check off the final box. Once you've got your form settings and your confirmation page configured the way you'd like, you can now come back to the middle of the page and begin creating your Google Form questions. This concludes this tutorial.